Hello and welcome back to another Photoshop tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how you can generate a color scheme from a photo. So the first thing you need to do is load up a photo onto your stage. Now once you have that done, you can go up to File and then down to Save for Web. Now once this dialog box opens, we can go ahead and zoom out so that we can see our whole photo. Now the first option we're going to adjust is the one that currently says JPEG. Now yours might say something else, but what we want to select is GIF. Now this is going to try and render this image as a GIF using anywhere between 2 and 256 colors. Now what I want you to direct your attention to is this option down here called Color Table, and this basically shows us swatches of every color that are currently being used to make up this image. Now that means that if we come up here to this colors dropdown, and instead of using say 256 colors, we change it to 8, it's then going to try and recreate that image using only 8 colors. So in doing that, Photoshop is going to automatically create and pick the 8 most dominant colors in the image so that it can try and recreate that, giving that to us down here on our color table. Now you can delete or modify or select certain color table color swatches, but I'm just going to leave all the defaults by deselecting them. And what we're going to do is go to this little menu here off to the side called Color Palette Menu, and we're going to go down to Save Color Table. So I'm just going to go ahead and put this on my desktop, and we can just call this, say, something like Sunset. I'm just going to go ahead and save that there. Now, we don't care how this image looks because we're not actually going to be saving it, so we can just go ahead and click Cancel. We're just using it to generate that color table. So now we can go ahead and pull off our Swatches menu, and we can open up its little menu up in the corner. So here we can actually reset the swatches, load the swatches, or replace the swatches, and I'm going to go ahead and go with the replace swatches option. So here what we want to do is look for that color table file that we just saved out. Now you might not see it even if it's in the same location that you saved it, but make sure and change the file type that you're looking for to color table. So once you do that, you should see the file. You can select it and then click load. So here you'll see in my swatches menu, now I have all the colors that were exported from that Save for Web and Devices dialog box, and now I can use those in my project as I see fit. So you can use them as a start to a design or in combination with other similar photography or any other styles that you want. So that's my time for today, but as always, if you enjoyed this tutorial, be sure to subscribe, rate, and comment for more.